हरे कृष्णा। हु इज श्रीमती राधा रानी? द ट्रूथ ऑफ श्रीमती राधा रानी। दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉन्फिडेंशियल नॉलेज। प्रबोधानंद सरस्वती राइट्स इन हिज वृंदावन महामामृता एज फॉलोज। Glorious are those persons who desire to climb out of the well of material existence and attain liberation. Even more glorious are they who have dedicated themselves to the service of the Lord. Even more elevated are those who have become attached to the lotus feet of Sri Krishna. Those who love the husband of Queen Rukmini are superior again to them. More praiseworthy still are those who are dear to the son of Yashoda. More glorious again are those who have made friends with the comrade of Subal. More glorious again than them are those who worship the Lord as the lover of the gopis. Yet, standing at the head of all the devotees in creation are those whose thoughts have been washed away by the great flow of sacred rapture emanating from the daughter of King Vrishbhanu, Radha, and worship her above all. Radha Rani is Haripriya, very dear to Krishna. So, if we approach Krishna through the mercy of Radha Rani, then it becomes very easy. If Radha Rani recommends that this devotee is very nice, then Krishna immediately accepts, however foolish I may be. Because Radha Rani recommends it, Krishna accepts. Therefore, in Vrindavan, you'll find all the devotees chanting Radha Rani's name more than Krishna's. You just try to please Radha Rani, then Krishna will be gotten very easily, because Radha Rani can deliver Krishna. She is such a great devotee. The emblem of Mahabhagavat, topmost level of devotion to Krishna. Even Krishna himself, though he says Vedaham Samatitani, I know everything, cannot understand Radha Rani's quality. Radha Rani is so great. Actually, Krishna knows everything, and in order to understand Radha Rani, Krishna accepts the position of Radha Rani in order to understand her potency. Krishna thought, I am full, I am complete in every respect, but still I want to understand Radha Rani. Why? This propensity made Krishna obliged to accept the propensities of Radha Rani to understand Krishna himself. The devotees are more interested in worshipping her, Radha Rani. This is because, however fallen I may be, if somehow or the other I can please Radha Rani, then it is very easy for me to understand Krishna. Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He resides in His transcendental abode, Golok Vrindavan, the topmost planet in the spiritual region called Vaikunth. Golok Vrindavan is an abode of bliss, of love. There, every step is a dance, every word a song. Devotion to Lord Krishna is the constitutional position of all living entities. And in the spiritual abode of Lord Krishna are His devotees, absorbed in different mellows of devotion to Him. In a land where Lord Krishna is the life and soul of everyone, Srimati Radha Rani is the topmost devotee. More than his servants, his friends, his parents, and all the cowherd damsels whose very center of existence is Krishna, is Srimati Radha Rani, the crest jewel of the most intimate lovers of Krishna. The truth of Srimati Radha Rani is enigmatic, mystical, far beyond the reach of the mundane consciousness. Krishna's energies are broadly categorized as three: internal, external, and marginal. While Lord Krishna takes pleasure in the internal energy personified by Srimati Radha Rani, He manifests the material world through the external energy personified by Durga Devi.
and the tiny living entities who can exist either under the influence of the internal energy or the external energy are his marginal energy. Srimati Radha Rani.
Srimati Radha Rani is the pleasure potency that Krishna enjoys. She is the root of the pure selfless feelings of service to Lord Krishna. She is the queen of the abode of perfect love. All that exists in that world is absorbed in innumerable feelings of intense love of God, nurtured by Srimati Radha Rani. She is the Aladini potency of Krishna. That Aladini energy gives Krishna pleasure and nourishes his devotees. Srila Jeev Goswami has elaborately discussed the Aladini potency in his Preeti Sandarbha. He says that the Vedas clearly state, only devotional service can lead one to the personality of Godhead. Only devotional service can help a devotee meet the Supreme Lord face to face. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is attracted by devotional service, and as such, the ultimate supremacy of Vedic knowledge rests in knowing the science of devotional service. As stated in Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Leela, while the material energy punishes the living entities in order to cure their selfish tendencies, Srimati Radha Rani, the internal pleasure potency of Krishna, fills them with the supreme devotional bliss of exclusively seeking Krishna's pleasure. Lord Krishna desires to know the mood of Radha. The ecstasy of Radha Rani in serving him was unfathomable to Lord Krishna. He decided to discover that bliss by assuming the mood of Radha Rani. So, he appeared as Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Lord Krishna, in the mood of Radha. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, during his earthly pastimes, gradually exhibited the pinnacle of the love of Krishna towards the end of his earthly pastimes. Like the grief-stricken gopis of Vrindavan, who felt acute separation from Krishna after he went away to Mathura, never to return, Lord Chaitanya listlessly wandered about in Jagannath Puri, feeling pangs of separation from Lord Krishna. He was immersed in this ultimate mood of devotion called Vipralamb Seva, service in a mood of separation. Lord Chaitanya could then taste the intense ecstasy of devotion felt by Srimati Radharani. Radha Bhavadyati Suvalitam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna, but he has accepted the propensities of Radharani. As Radharani is always feeling separation from Krishna, similarly, in the position of Radharani, Lord Chaitanya was feeling separation from Krishna. That is the teaching of Lord Chaitanya. Feelings of separation, not meeting. The process of devotional service taught by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his disciplic succession is how to feel separation from Krishna, and that is Radharani's position, always feeling that separation. Mercy of Guru and Gauranga. For anyone with even the faintest tinge of selfishness, the divine, loving nature of Radharani is impossible to understand or interpret. Yet, by the infinite grace of Srila Prabhupada and Lord Chaitanya, even a hopelessly conditioned soul can gain an appreciation of the goings-on in the supreme abode of Lord Krishna. If the aspiring devotee takes complete shelter of Srimati Radharani, the supreme devotee, his hopelessly selfish heart will quickly transform to feel the urgent desire to make Krishna his all in all. Mahabhav Swarupa Shri Radha Thakurani Sarvagun Khani Krishna Kanta Shiromani. Shri Radha Thakurani is the embodiment of Mahabhav. She is the repository of all good qualities and the crest jewel among all the lovely consorts of Lord Krishna. Srimati Radharani is the personified embodiment of these three aspects of transcendental consciousness. She is therefore the highest principle in love of Godhead and is the supreme lovable object of Sri Krishna, as stated in Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Leela.
Srila Sanatan Goswami says that
the privilege of serving Sri Radha is the rarest goal of life, and it is fitting that this privilege be attainable only by executing the most excellent of sadhanas.
Srila Roop Goswami and Srila Vishwanath Chakravartipad has explained a verse as follows in his Anand Chandrika purport.
Sri Mani Manjari instructed a new Manjari. My dear clever girl, I am telling you from my own experience. It is better you make friends with Srimati Radha. You may ask, why should I form a loving relation with Srimati Radha? Rather, is it not better to establish a loving relation with Sri Krishna? No, it is not. I'll tell you why. Please listen carefully. No doubt it is highly pleasurable to get Sri Hari's love. But if you love Srimati Radharani deeply, then that precious pleasure will present itself to you on its own. This is because love for Sri Krishna is included within your love for Srimati Radha. Hence, if you make friends with her, it is needless to say that a loving relation with Sri Krishna will form naturally. When you become Srimati Radharani's firm sakhi, then Sri Krishna will consider you as his beloved's dear friend, and so he will love you all the more. He will not love you so much if you make friends with him directly. However, he will love you more if you love her. So, I'm telling you, if you can prove your love for Srimati Radharani, then Sri Krishna will love you, even if you do not try for it. Sri Krishna is happier when our love for Srimati Radharani is more than our love for him. Also, when Srimati Radharani does man, or if the elders shut her up in the house, then Sri Krishna will need you desperately to help him meet her. Then he will on his own run behind you to make friends with you. You see, you don't have to work hard to make friends with him. The one who has not worshipped the dust of Srimati Radharani's lotus feet, has not taken shelter of Sri Vrindavan that is decorated with her footprints, has not conversed with the great devotees who are deeply immersed in Srimati Radharani's servitude,
how will such a person ever relish the most mysterious, fathomless ocean of rus, that is, Sri Krishna, as stated in Stavavali?
Srimati Radharani's servitude is not a mean thing. It is the highest position or the most blessed status. Srimati Radharani's maid servant is a servant in spite of being a sakhi. She has the right to the entire sweet rus. First, she relishes sweet rus and then she performs seva. Therefore, Srimati Radharani's servitude is overflowing with rus.
The reason that almost all of our acharyas preached Radha Dasyam is no coincidence.
They want us to practice Radha Dasyam, and that is the only reason that the Gotikas of Gopal Guru Goswami, Dhyan Chandra Goswami, Siddha Krishna Das Goswami only refer to practice of Manjari Bhav, maidservant of Srimati Radharani. Don't try to understand Radha Krishna very quickly. It is a very big subject. If we want to understand Radha Krishna very quickly, then there will be so many Prakrata Sahajiyas. Radha Krishna philosophy has to be understood by the liberated person, not by the conditioned soul. So, we shall await for the fortunate moment when we are liberated. Then we shall understand Radha Krishna Pranay Vikritir. Because Krishna and Radha, they are not on the material field. Try to understand.
This is Jeev Goswami's analysis that Krishna is the Supreme Brahman.
The Supreme Brahman cannot accept anything material. So, Radha is not in the material field. Srimati Radharani is as fully spiritual as Krishna. No one should consider her to be material. She is definitely not like the conditioned souls who have mental bodies, gross and subtle, covered by material senses. She is all spiritual, and both her body and mind are of the same spiritual embodiment. Because her body is spiritual, her senses are also spiritual. Thus, her body, mind and senses fully shine in love of Krishna. Hare Krishna.